Federal Reserve officials announced that they are prepared to fight inflation with a series of interest rate hikes next year, suggesting it will begin earlier than they projected just months ago. The Fed's benchmark interest rate, which affects borrowing, lending, and economic growth, has been near zero since the start of the pandemic in an effort to boost the recovery. But today, Fed Chair Jay Powell said there could be as many as 3 rate hikes next year, starting in the spring, in an effort to cool persistent rising prices.
High inflation imposes significant hardship, especially on those least able to meet the higher costs of essentials, like food, housing, and transportation. We are committed to our price stability goal. We will use our tools both to support the economy and a strong labor market, and to prevent higher inflation from becoming entrenched.
The Fed also announced that it will scale back even further its efforts to stimulate the economy through major bond purchases. For more on these moves and their potential impact, we turn to Julia Coronado. She's an economist at the University of Texas at Austin, the founder of the firm Macro Policy Perspectives, and she is a former economist for the Fed. Julia Coronado, welcome back to the NewsHour. This is a pretty dramatic announcement. Why is the Fed doing this?
Well, the message from Chair Powell today was it's not just about inflation that has been running pretty high in recent months, but the labor market is really strong. The economy is basically running pretty hot. We've seen the unemployment rate drop substantially. We've seen really significant wage gains. Interest-sensitive sectors like housing are running really strong. So the economy doesn't need as much support from monetary policy as it once did. Despite all the turbulence from ongoing waves of COVID, the economy is doing really well, and the Fed has concluded that it needs to start pulling back, start stepping away. It's not trying to kill the recovery, it's just trying to cool things off and again, keep that inflation in check, as the clip you just played indicated.
So what effect is the increase in interest rates expected to have on the economy?
Well, over time, as the Fed raises interest rates, consumers should see somewhat higher interest rates for mortgage loans, for car loans, and businesses should see maybe some tighter terms to obtain financing. We've seen some really easy financial conditions in the last year. And so we should expect to see a bit tighter conditions and a little bit higher prices to obtain credit in particular. So it's those credit sensitive sectors that the Fed would like to see cool down just a little bit.
And the other thing the Fed announced is they are shrinking these monthly bond purchases. They're going to be doing this much faster than they had said. How's that going to affect the economy?
Same channels. The bond purchases work by lowering, putting downward pressure on longer-term interest rates after they've lowered short-term interest rates to zero. So as they back away from these purchases, we should see some of those longer-term interest rates move higher. And also, there are spillovers to other areas of the financial markets. The stock market's been really running really strong. We've seen a lot of, you might call it, froth in areas like cryptocurrencies. And that kind of sort of enthusiasm may see some cooling as the Fed stops injecting liquidity into financial markets.
Are most analysts at this stage saying that these are the right moves at the right time and the right pace?
Yeah, well, there's a lot of mixed views. And let's be clear, the uncertainty around even just next year continues to be really, really high, given the pandemic, given different potential outcomes for fiscal policy. So there's differing views. The markets took the Fed's announcement actually extraordinarily well, surprisingly well, given that they were unambiguously declaring the easing of policy is going to be in the rearview mirror soon. So there isn't really any indication from financial markets that the Fed is either tightening too soon or even really that it's tightening too late. So right now they're giving the Fed a lot of credibility and there's no real indications of turmoil or concern that they're about to kill the recovery.
To what extent did you listen to the Fed chair today? To what extent did you hear him acknowledge that the Fed had been misreading the economy over the last year?
Chair Powell was actually very forthcoming, and he's been pretty clear all along that this is an unprecedented economic environment. We've never been in a global pandemic. When it looked like the global economy was sliding into a depression, the Fed and fiscal policymakers threw everything they had at it. And the other side of that may be that we've got a recovery that's a little hotter than they anticipated, and so they're recalibrating policy accordingly. But he's been very clear that they don't have any magic wand. They don't have a crystal ball. They're reading things as best as they can. Part of the idea that inflation was going to be transitory was that so much of it has come from supply chain disruptions, things like semiconductor shortages that have pushed car prices higher, rather than sort of wages and a broad base of prices. That dynamic is shifting a little bit, and that's one of the reasons that they've shifted strategy a little bit. So they're going to continue to be very flexible as we move forward, given the uncertainty. Things can, the economy can evolve in unanticipated ways, and they will be there to recalibrate policy accordingly with the ultimate objective of a long, stable expansion like we had last time.
And we heard him say, use that word, stable, stability. Finally, how soon should consumers who are listening to this and watching expect to feel that things are changing?
Well, it's going to be a gradual process. So they've sped it up, but they're still indicating 3 rate hikes for next year. That means it could come, they're going to end their bond purchases in March. So we could see rate hikes in June, maybe June, September, and December would be a reasonable baseline expectation. So you could start to see rates creeping higher over the next year. So again, this is not a, you know, ripping off the Band-Aid. This is a gradual, more methodical removal of accommodation that consumers will feel over time.
Julia Coronado, thank you very much.
My pleasure.